How long you been here? 1 year.
24
huh?
hours.
We wish. 24 hours, yeah? Okay, that's good. It's just time for you to rest and, you know, get used to the environment, huh? Who told you to come here? You like?
Yes.
Good. I'm glad that you like. Very good. Everybody happy?
Yeah.
那个吃饭的都好哈。
好。
Eat well, yeah?
Yeah. Well, 谢谢师傅。
嗯，不客气，不客气。Any question? No?
No.
Good. That means you are enlightened, huh? 不问的话就。是啊，就说去哪里啊？我去看师父，就来多看吧啊。事实上应该这样了哈、啊，任何的语言都是这样这么说了。我去看他，我去看啊，妈妈，我去看了姐姐，我看妹妹哈、啊，谁都说去看，嗯，为什么呢？本来我们看眼睛就够了。如果我们心灵很好的话，灵性比较高的话，看眼睛就行了，嗯，所以古代的人在就用这样嘛，我去看他，啊，看的什么意思呢？用眼睛看啊，是不是？然后另外那个人也，对方也用，也看我们呢，这表示说我们人哈，应该是。用看就行了，啊，这个默默那个是第二级的，不过没关系嘛，第二级中没每级哈，第三级也好嘛哈，来这边有什么级都好哈，哎，喜欢这样。不过我们人哈修行本来应该用智慧眼就 OK 了。然后什么人互相爱的话，用眼睛看就够了。就是因为我们呢，久了就忘记这个系统了，都眼睛不看啊，继续看下去就有问题了。这边看就够了，你如果继续看下面就不一样了。啊，继续看下面就等一下就不看了，啊，就变成不同的系统了。OK， 嗯。修行的人哈，越高也越不用那个物质的方面哈，看眼睛已经是不是说第一层了，第一级了，看眼睛就第二级了，不看了在里面沟通才是第一级的 ，OK， 嗯，第一级在里面哈，第二级看眼睛，第三级摸头。我们灵魂到处都在嘛，哈 ，OK， 好，告诉你，哎，这个世界真很乱，还好现在我们 OK 了哈，强壮了哈，
谢师傅，
连吸烟也小了，最近我看那个 我看新闻哈，那个牛排也少吃了。美国特别现在也很小了，听说小下去了，少那个猪肠啊，然后少吃，两边都少，少人吃就少猪肠嘛哈啊。那我们继续努力的话，也许总有一天整个世界都世俗的呢，会变很善良的哈。善良然后有福报啊。
Some of the benefits of a vegetarian diet: lowers blood pressure, lowers cholesterol levels, reduces type 2 diabetes, prevents stroke conditions, reverses atherosclerosis, reduces heart disease risk 50%, reduces heart surgery risk 80%, prevents many forms of cancer.Stronger immune system increases life expectancy up to 15 years. Higher IQ saves 70% of the total cost of $40 trillion for reducing global warming. Uses 4.5 times less land to grow food. Conserves up to 70% clean water. Saves 80% of the cleared Amazonian rainforest from animal grazing. A solution for world hunger.Free up 3.4 billion hectares of land. Free up 760 million tons of grain every year, half the world's grain supply. Consumes one-third fossil fuels of those used for meat production. Reduces pollution from untreated animal waste. Maintains cleaner air. Saves 4.5 tons of emissions per U.S. household per year. Stop 80% of global warming.Plus more.
哎呀，这个世界真的困难。也不是说西洋人或是东洋人啊，反正就是那种阿修罗的那个众生哈，会杀凡啊，然后混进去啊，然后给人家迷倒这样子。比方说有时候他们又不想卖鸦片啊，就是因为有一些阿修罗的众生啊，叫他下去嘛，给人家那个混淆啊，骗人呢、啊、他可以下来留几天嘛，一两个礼拜也够了啊，然后就诱惑人家，跟人家讲这个那个那个啊，等一下才这样变成上瘾，然后才有问题。不然如果我们这个世界没有阿修罗众生的话还会好的，就是因为太靠近阿修罗众生嘛，太靠近了，所以他上来下去很方便，我们上去不容易，他下去很简单，没有他没有身体嘛，他可以变化比较多样，我们人没有神通，很小了啊，就阿修罗都有神通，那个连那个小福报的阿修罗也会有神通，有一些有一点福报的他更大的神通，然后就上来下去这样迷惑人啊，调皮嘛，有时候也是恶劣啊，有时候也是因为前世有仇恨的关系下来报仇，把这个人害死，那个人害死，这样他不能杀人，他就诱惑人家，叫人家赌嘛，鸦片啊，赌马费啊，然后赌博啊，比方说这样，或是那个喝酒啊等等，都是引诱人家这样的，然后后来人如果听他的话以后就完了，很难回去那个以前那个安平那个时候，这人很可怜哦，因为人有时候有愁有闷嘛，啊，然后他那个趁那个人的愁闷的时候哈，不防备哈，然后精神比较脆弱哈，他就下来诱惑人家，啊，人家刚好又愁没有想，精神又比较不很强壮，就被他诱惑，然后喝酒啊，或是赌麻费哈，啊。等一下就会上瘾，以后就不能很难那个控制了， 就是这样了。所以我们修行人啊，不要忧愁，有乐观才比较好。音乐的话，哎，也要听乐观的哈，偶尔一点没关系，就是听也可以听，就不要忧愁就对了。OK， 听好玩没关系哈，就不能有那种忧愁的精神。有忧愁的精神就容易被那个无形众生那个诱惑，知道哈？这个世界都满满嘛，太靠近阿修罗嘛。然后他们都在这边呢，已经很久了，混来混去了，上来下去很久，所以很多人都被迷惑掉了，精神都不一样。然后就变成他们的工具。那些着魔那些都是因为忧愁的时候让他们进来，把他靠近了习惯了，然后他就进来出去这样子。那我们修行的人有保护。
Some of the tragic tolls of addictive drug abuse. Over 200,000 deaths each year. Costs of $181 billion each year in the United States. $33 billion in the UK. Lifetime cost of current drug addiction amounts to $575 billion in the UK. Harmful effects, brain damage, stroke,heart disease, liver disease, tuberculosis, emphysema, cancer, depression, suicide, permanent memory loss, mental illness, higher infant mortality, increased crime and violence, impotence. Crime and violence. Illegal drugs are a factor in 50% of burglaries in the United Kingdom each year. In the US, 60% of people arrested each year have been taking illegal drugs.650 heroin addicts in the U.S. committed 70,000 crimes in a three-month period. Social costs. U.S. businesses lose $100 billion per year due to employees' drug and alcohol abuse. Australians pay $53 billion per year for healthcare, law enforcement, and lost productivity of drug users. Environmental costs.Every gram of cocaine produced destroys 4.4 square meters of rainforest, with 300,000 hectares of rainforest lost each year to cocaine production. Death. 52 people die each day due to drugs in the U.S. In Canada, substance abuse is attributed to 21% of total deaths and 23% of potential life years lost due to early mortalities. Plus more.For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers.
For help quitting, please visit Some of the Tragic Tolls of Tobacco, 5.4 million smoking-related deaths per year worldwide.Cost of smoking-related illnesses, $96 billion in the United States alone. Depression. Light and mild cigarettes, just as harmful, causes cancer and diseases in animal companions, speeds the aging process. Toxic residues of third-hand smoke. Heart disease, coronary thrombosis, cerebral thrombosis, kidney failure.
Cancer.Mouth, liver, breast, and colorectal cancer, lung cancer, esophagus cancer, kidneys cancer, bladder cancer, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, emphysema, bronchitis,
stroke, impotence, additional harms for secondhand smoking, childhood arteriosclerosis, leading to heart attacks and strokes in adulthood, sudden infant death syndrome, infertility,miscarriages and premature deliveries, childhood asthma, bronchitis, ear infection, cleft lip or palate, hyperactivity and aggression in asthmatic boys, circulatory problems in women. Plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers. For help quitting, please visit
You know why people go to Mecca, don't you? That was when the Master was alive. They say, once in a lifetime, at least you have to go to Mecca. Why? To see the Master. Not like everybody can go even. You know, some people more difficult than you to go there. Yeah, more difficult. Still go. So, you know now, huh? Yeah, even if you're initiated already, but once in a lifetime, you should go to Mecca. Yes? It's to see the Master, yeah? To, you know, reinforce. Yeah, feel like you really got initiation. Something like that, you know? Yes, so that is the thing. I know why the Buddha say the enlightened person should eat only once a day. You know, he and his monks only eat once a day. I guess it's inconvenient to go out and take arms, you know, all day. But after a while, he has a disciple, I think, that will bring food to him, no? But I understand why he take one meal a day, I guess. Too many disciples and no time. Okay, now you know why, huh? You know, why people have to go to Mecca once a while. Once a lifetime, at least they say that. Yeah, in India they also say, you know, at least once in a lifetime you should go and see the Master. But you come see more than just once in a lifetime. I don't understand it. Lucky, yeah?
Yeah. So happy.
Happy also? Okay, good. I saw her all the time. Every time she can come, she come. How you do that?
I'm lost to you, miss me every time.
Can you believe this? I'm worried about her, but she doesn't worry at all. Because of all the stories she told me, I'm worried to death about her. And look at her, just come here. I don't worry about anything. Master always give me money. She's a walking miracle, you know? Who say that the practitioner cannot use miracles? She's using it all the time. Oh, baby.
I know,
but Jesus, you come only a few days.
It doesn't matter.
How is everybody there? So you don't have any question for the time being? Yeah. Tell me, love.
First, I want to thank you for helping my mother. I was full up with all the trouble for my mother, and you really blessed me. And when I got home, you just fixed everything, that it all worked out. So thank you very much.
Wonderful.
I've been initiated for 12 years, and my mother's an alcoholic, and my brother's an alcoholic.
Yeah.
And I don't know what's wrong with me, that I can't influence them in a positive way to help them break free from that.
No, they are just your test.
And now my brother's in prison, Master.
Oh, I tell you. Yeah, because of alcohol, and then lost the head.
Yeah, and then when I try and help him, Master, I have a conflict. I don't know if I should help, because when I help, he gets into more trouble. And when I don't help, I have conflict inside of myself.
I understand. Help like what? They give him money to drink?
No, like this time he went to prison, they locked him up. And then the lawyer wanted me to pay the bail to get him out. And I really didn't want to, but I felt conflict for not being compassionate.
I understand.
So then I did help Master, but then he went out again and he went to the casino again, and then he got locked up again, and then they withdrew his bail, and now it's even worse than what it was if I hadn't helped.
I understand. Let him learn his lesson, baby.
Yeah, I don't know when to help and when not to help.
It's okay. Maybe he should learn his lesson in there. Yeah?
Because then I'm torn between my mother, being loyal to my mother, and being loyal to myself and my practice.
I understand.
But then I also can't practice well with all of this going on.
I understand. What is about mother? Mother's okay now?
Mother's much better, although she's still hurting. She was in a relationship with a man for 15 and a half years. And he found another woman, and he just came home one night and he said, okay, tonight our paths end. He broke up the relationship.
Okay.
But the way he did it was very hurtful.
Just too quick, right?
So quick, no warning, no kindness, no nothing.
Well, maybe better like that.
And then because I'd lost all that money, I panicked because I didn't feel I could take care of my mother. But then you took care of that and you helped her get a very good settlement. So she's financially secure now.
Oh,
and that's why I'm saying thank you to you, because I know it was you that did it.
Yeah, but she should stop drinking, you know.
I know, Marston. I don't know how to tell.
It's
I've talked
not very
to them.
Good for her, yeah.
I talk to her all the time about you.
Oh, never mind. Don't worry, you know.
So I don't know how to convince them.
Remember what Jesus say?
Yes.
Who is my mother? Only the one who do the will of God is my relatives and friends. This is a sad things in the world. You know, sometimes the biggest test is our family members. Sometimes like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just lucky, you know. I'm just lucky. My parents, my sister and my relatives, they just follow me by themselves. I did not even go knock at their door and tell nothing. Because I was thinking, oh, I don't think they would even believe me anyway, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And they did believe.
I lose my temper and I get cross.
That has nothing to do with them. Before you follow me, they drink already. Mm-hmm. You know, it has nothing to do with you. And once they're hooked, it's very difficult to get out. I told you. And once they drink, many of the astral beings also will take advantage of that. They go nearby them or they go into their body now and again just to enjoy when they drink. Because they cannot drink, so they borrow the body, you know.
Yeah.
Yes. And the more you drink, the more they come, and those dark influence is very difficult to get rid of. Unless the person wants to, you see? Yeah.
And I've explained that to them also, Master, what you've just said now, from your teachings.
Yeah.
And they're stubborn.
Oh, forget it. No. Don't bother, okay?
Some of the tragic tolls of alcohol. 2.3 million alcohol-related deaths per year worldwide. Cost of alcohol-related illnesses, $186.4 billion U.S. dollars in the United States. Up to $210 to $665 billion U.S. dollars globally.
Disease. Higher amounts of alcohol increase the cancer risk. Even half a glass of wine daily increases the risk of mouth or throat cancer by 168%. Cancer of the liver, breast, colon, esophagus, rectum, liver disease, cardiovascular disease, metal toxicity, brain damage, amnesia and dementia, brain shrinkage,
organ failure, heart, liver, kidneys, stomach, pancreas, eyes,
birth defects, children afflicted by anxiety and depression, mental retardation, fetal alcohol syndrome, stunted growth, facial deformity, sudden infant death syndrome, miscarriage.
Alcohol-related violence. Child abuse, 50% of cases. Violence toward loved ones, 30% of cases. Violent acts, 40 to 80% of cases. Suicides, 20 to 50% of cases. Plus more.
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers. For help quitting, please visit.
And then last, I have another silly question, but it's been hindering my mind for over a year now.
Tell me.
For some strange reason, I was driving on my way to work one day and I saw this house and I wasn't even looking to buy a house. And I ended up buying this house. In my heart, I felt that you had given it to me as a gift. And I was able to afford it and it's really a beautiful home and the garden is magnificent.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
And then?
And then I've been living there for 5 years and really happy.
Uh-huh.
And then this developer came along. He was going to do a massive big development of building and everything and whatnot, but he promised he wouldn't go over a certain boundary of my property. And Master, he of course broke all the promises he tore out all the trees.
Oh,
and
good.
I have been struggling for a year to keep telling myself that I must let it go, I must detach myself from it. It's just either karmic hindrance or his turn will come. But I'm not able to let go of it because also in this time now, my property is devalued by 50%. He's taken away all my view. He's made a mess of our gardens.
Oh, God.
All the bees are busy dying. I don't know why they keep dying on the floor. They just fall down and they just crawl around and they die.
Oh, God.
And the birds and everything. So he really made a mess. And all they think about is all the money they're making.
Understand.
And I'm on one side angry and resentful, but at the same time I'm trying to be a good practitioner.
Very difficult.
I've been struggling to work this out on my own.
How come you always run into something? My God. Sell the house.
What is it about me? Just sell the house. I can't sell it now. I tried to sell it, and the price that they want to give me is even lower than what my bond is.
Oh, God.
So I have to wait now until the development is finished.
Yeah. How long?
Another year.
Oh, my God.
In the meantime, I get angry and I get frustrated with the noise and the dust and everything. But it's not even just that, Master. It's more the energy that I feel inside with these people.
Yeah.
You know, the greed and the my resentment.
Understand.
So how am I going to let this go, Master? I've tried without asking you to help me, except I ask you, of course, in my room at night. Tell me what I must
do. You really attract so many stuff.
But what is it about me, Master? What's wrong with me? Why do I have such heavy karma that I have to bear these strange things? What did I choose this for?
Maybe because this world is like that.
So do I just continue the way I am, Master?
You should, if you can, you sell the house and be free, you know? Mm. Just rent a studio. That's all you need, truly. Mm. I told you guys many times already, live with the initiate or rent a studio. If I don't have so many children, I never want a house. No, no, no.
Yeah.
Just a studio is good enough. What for? You need a lot of big house. No, no need.
No, it's just my mother's living with me now.
She is now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The good news, Master, she went vegetarian.
Oh,
complete
wow.
Vegetarian.
Vegetarian and with alcohol.
She will last. And we started a vegetable garden, Master.
Huh?
And we started a vegetable garden together.
Oh, that's wonderful. Okay, at least make her plan a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Make her busy, okay?
Yeah. Thank you, Master, for your love.
Tell her that she should quit, huh?
Can I tell her that you told me to tell her?
Yeah, sure, sure.
Thank you, Master. She respects you, Master.
Tell her that's for her own sake, yeah?
Mm.
And for you, she should start to straighten up, yeah?
Okay.
There are companies that help, you know, Alcohol Anonymous or something. It's difficult for a while, but then once you break it, 3 weeks, you'll be done.
Mm.
Everything you start for 3 weeks long, you will stop, you know, like begin a new habit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you, Master.
I'm so sorry. You have a lot of tests.
But you've helped me a lot, Master. In the 12 years, you really have helped me a lot.
If I haven't helped you, you probably would have broke down, huh?
I would have killed myself a long time ago.
You must have been gone, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's because difficult. Of you.
It's difficult to live in this life, and it's difficult to have to deal with so many things like that. But that makes you strong.
But I want to be strong and nice, Master, and good inside, and high level, and everything.
Oh.
And it's hard.
You know, we can't have everything. That's what makes you strong. All this trouble. You see what I mean? You're very strong. Imagine if somebody else, could they bear that?
I don't know, Master, but I know I have you, and that's the one thing that's made me the happiest person in my entire life is you, and that's why I come every time. And yes, I am addicted to you. Thank you.
Okay, it's good that you know that I'm good for you. Yeah. Well, we need a friend, you know, in this life. Yeah. Even distant friend is better than no friend. The friend who understands us, the friend who are with us. No matter what, and it's a comfort, yeah? Mm. Well, I'm very sorry you have to go through so much. In the Buddha's time, there was a nun, you know. Originally, he doesn't want to take nun because he has only bachelor guys together, and if mixed with nuns, would be trouble, you know. Also, in those times, monks had to go out beg for food, you know, rain or shine, and it would be more difficult for the woman to go out like that. And in India, women are not supposed to go out alone, even nowadays. Yes. If you go out alone as a woman, people look down upon you, like not a decent woman. Hmm. If you go out, you better go, even with a kid, okay. Maybe a cow or something. India cow running around, so it's normal. Yeah. Just attach to him to you and then go with you, and then people think, oh, she's just tending a cow, it's okay. In Buddha's time, there was a nun who came and became renunciate with the Buddha. Oh, she told her story. It's horrible. Like she was robbed, you know? And then her house was on fire, and then later her husband was killed, you know? Murder, and then her children were drowned, you know, in a river all in front of her. And that's how she felt, finally, that life is truly not worth clinging to, because you never know when what happened. Really, at that time, you know, after going through all that, in a short period of time, a few years, and she really see through the ephemeral nature of life, and she left. Wow. But, you know, she has nothing anymore, so it's easier to leave, eh? But otherwise, she could not. Who would want to leave a husband and so many lovely children and a wonderful house, you know, peaceful life? She couldn't do that before. She has followed the Buddha, but she would never be able to be a renunciate like that. I mean, not just wearing the robe of a nun, but she really was through. See what I mean? Really detached from life. That because of all this incident happened in her life. Hmm. Luckily, she didn't have any debt, honey, you see. That's the problem.
Started making money again.
Yeah? Oh, wonderful. Just pay all debt off, okay? Okay. And let your mother stay in your house. Yeah, you have company. It's good. It's okay. But even with a mother, you can just have an apartment, you know.
Yeah.
Two room or something is good enough. House is big, huh? How many rooms you have?
3 bedrooms.
Yeah, wow. And a living room and a kitchen and some washer room. Yeah. Maybe a little breakfast niche. Yeah.
And office.
Oh my God, so that doesn't count even?
No.
Whoa.
It's got my mother's office, my mother's home, my home, and my office.
Oh,
all
my
in
God.
One.
Oh, my God.
But it's the garden that I'm attached to, Master.
Garden. Oh, of course, it's nice to
trees,
have a garden.
Yeah.
Yes, of course.
Very beautiful.
Never mind. Whatever he broke, you plant it back, okay? You can plant it overnight also. You can plant those, you buy a big tree,
yeah.
And the company will come and dig a big hole with a crane,
yeah.
And they put it there. In a few weeks, it will regrow again. Normally, they trim it, you see? Mm. And it looked like short hair. And you plant it in your water, after a few weeks or a few months, it grow like a big tree already.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
If it doesn't destroy your soul, that's very good already. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah.
You know what? Of course, because you had it better before.
Mm.
So now, because it's ruined, so you feel bad. But if you just came right now and you had no home, yes.
I would like it.
Yes. And then somebody just say, oh, this is a home ready for you. You come in. And then you would not mind the crane, the noise, the trees, broken, nothing. Truly like that.
And 7 stories in front of me. And 7 stories.
I know, but some people don't even have that home to live in.
Mm.
Yeah. Of course, before it was better. You know that already before you buy the house, okay? You know that the front they're going to build, because it's not like a forbidden forest or something. Mm-hmm. Sooner or later, if he doesn't build, somebody else will build. Maybe he'll build even 17 story. You know, another guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and even take longer. So look at that way, huh? Yeah.
It's just I get upset with myself also, Master, that after so many years of practicing that I still feel attachment.
No, it's normal, it's normal. It's normal. Just forgive yourself. Allow yourself that sentiment.
Okay.
It's very normal. But don't let it ruin your life. That's it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
If you're upset, okay. Why not? Everybody will get upset, okay? Mm-hmm. So if you upset because you're upset, that will make you even more upset. So just accept it, you know? Yeah. You're still in a human body, you have human emotion. I would be upset.
Yeah.
If suddenly somebody built 7-story in front of my house and ruined my garden, and I have to bear it for many years with noise and crane and, you know, banging, you know, of course I get upset, you know.
Okay.
But to get upset is one thing, you know, and to get upset about being upset is another thing. Yeah, because the attachment is not about being upset about your house, no. But attachment is about that you should not be upset. You set your standard like this, but you could not reach. If you're upset, why not? Everybody would be upset in that situation. Tell me, wouldn't you be upset?
Yes.
Anyone. So just don't think that you're so big shot that you couldn't or should not be upset. That's the problem. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Yes. It's okay. We got upset. I got upset too, you know. But then I continue my work. Huh? I know I'm upset. I got upset. I don't like it. I cannot say, oh, I'm so happy, you know. I allow myself to be upset. Because it's a normal reaction, yeah? But I don't upset and then think about that all the time. Maybe 1-3 days, okay, and then I continue my work, or else, or else I'll be ruined because of that. Yeah? I don't let that ruin me. So you don't let your upsetness ruin you, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Right, you're welcome. If you can sell the house and buy a smaller one, maybe better. Also have garden. Smaller house, cheaper, have garden also. Yeah? But if you cannot, then just bear the karma, eh? What can we do? Yeah? Very difficult to live in this world, okay?
Yes, Master.
Sometimes when I have a difficult, I take Master for example. I'm thinking, Master's so busy, she can overcome. Why? I'm not.
No, because I don't eat, I don't sleep, that's why.
So.
That's how.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, of course, sometimes I eat whenever I have time, I eat, you know, quick. Yeah. And if I don't have time, I don't eat. If I have time, I sleep. If I don't have time, I just don't sleep. Very simple. Yeah? Very simple, yeah. I told you. All the people are innocent and good. It's just the astral being. They come and they make trouble. That's why I try to help people, because I know that they are just pitiful, you know? They are victim of this kind of terrible world. And this world is already very bad. Yeah, and then the astral being has to come and make trouble as well. That is the more trouble, you see? So we human, if we don't practice spiritually, we're hopeless, truly hopeless. Maximum is that you could go to the astral level after you die, that's it. There's no future for us, yes?
But overall, Master, it's getting better, and we hear good news now,
yes,
and it's so encouraging.
Yes.
We elected a new president. We had our fingers crossed. We were just praying so hard. And
for him to be elected?
Yeah, for him to be elected.
And why, you like him so much?
Yeah, he's going to do so many good things for the country. He had to keep quiet, you know, about really some of the things he intends to do before was elected. He didn't come out and speak openly, but after he's elected already, we've seen him give talks about the environment. And even about how people need to eat less meat.
Wow.
You know,
Bravo.
He said he has learned that it's not good for the environment, and we're going to have to make some changes.
Sacrifice. Oh, yeah.
And he said that he's going to create jobs for the people that are for the environment.
Yes.
And so many good things, you know.
Good.
We're so grateful.
I'm glad for you.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, whoever can win like that, you know, I mean, he must have been really good.
Yeah. Yes. It's
he must
so
have been
hard.
Good in his heart.
Yeah, so he's a good man.
So that the heaven helped him.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it wouldn't be possible.
So we pray for his protection and that he can, you know, live long and do all these good
if
things.
If he's that good, he will be okay.
Yeah.
If he's that good, he'll be okay.
He has so many good ideas, and he understands the logic of this world, you know, that if these things are bad for the environment, then we need to quit it. You know,
yes,
whereas
that's it.
The others, they just ignored it and tried
to
hush-hush.
I don't know how they ignore it. I don't know how people can ignore such things. That is truly already evidence that the world is going down, and I don't know why they ignore it. Yeah. Every day I look at some big guy just talking about, okay, new energy, changing bulbs, you know, cut down on petrol, using sustainable car or electric car, but I don't hear often about vegetarian. I don't understand why. Never mind. We shall be patient.
But, you know, Master, we keep hearing good news about the vegetarianism.
Now.
My husband teaches in the military system, you know, for children whose parents are in the military.
Yeah.
It's difficult in our community to openly, you know, spread flyers and things like that, but he manages to get through the back door. He has a club that's connected with the Jane Goodall Foundation, and they have to have projects that help animals, the environment, and people.
Yeah.
And so he showed his kids one of the advertisement for SMTV about global warming, and one of the trailers for the 11th hour, and his kids were so touched by it that they said, we need to do something. Yes. We need to be vegetarian.
Yeah.
We need to get vegetarian food in the school cafeteria.
They don't know, otherwise they do it. Yeah. All the kids are very, very pure, and they're very smart.
And so the kids wanted to get vegetarian meals in the school cafeteria, you know, and so my husband encouraged them, and so they wrote a letter to the people who are in charge of this you know, for the system.
Yeah.
And it turns out that the lady who is in charge of all the schools, the American schools, the military schools worldwide, had just the day before gone to some show or conference or something where she had the chance to taste vegetarian food samples. And she said she was so impressed and she liked them. And she said they were thinking of doing this, of offering it in all the schools worldwide, you know?
Wow.
And so, you know, my husband felt so happy. We were so happy because it felt like so long he's banging his head against the wall and nothing happening. And then suddenly it just opens up, you know? So it's so encouraging. So,
I know,
you know,
but it's
the
too
good
slow.
Is, it's happening.
It's happening. In America, they eat less meat now. They say very, very low now.
Good.
Less production of meat and less meat eaters now. Of course, but I still feel that's not good enough. Quickly, my God. 2,000 islands sinking. 14 already gone. Another 40 is already half gone. Another 2,000 is going. And that is for now, but maybe more, we don't even know. Some islands are uninhabitable and nobody even report, or maybe don't care. Or some people don't report, you know. Like if we didn't have Supreme Master Television, we would never know, like, many country population has to move to another island, and then that island also sinking, and then now they have to move to another island. We would never know that. You see? Maybe one or two person know, but a little bit here and there, nobody ever gather all the information in one source so anybody can look like that every day. I already told, we research on that, and we're going to put it on for Supreme Master Television for people to see, huh? Yeah. Just because it doesn't affect them, it doesn't mean it doesn't affect yet, you know? And also even England coastline and Alaska coastal area, they are eroding. Not just some island somewhere. But because there's so many and different places, so people don't even notice. You know what I mean? And not everybody live on the coastal area, you know, and not everybody live on island, so they think they're safe. They don't know much about it. But how safe, you know? It's not just about the climate change, but it's the effect of it, you know, and the consequences if we don't do anything. Not just those islands. Okay. All right. Meanwhile, if you have garden, you plant vegetable? Yeah. Plant the the simple ones, easy but nutritious, you know, like beans and stuff, fruit trees, yeah. Anything that's easy and quick. Yeah, so you get used to doing this, and then you have your own food, okay? Don't wait until food shortage, or don't wait until something happens, okay? Be prepared, all right? Okay? Be prepared. Don't go too far. You just go as far as you can. Just get used to it a little bit. Tell yourself that you can go without food also, if you have to. But plant food, yeah? And just get used to it, all kind of situation. Make yourself acquainted with. Don't wait, okay?
Can I just say one more
thing?
Sure,
please.
I just want to say that we know that all the good changes that are happening are only due to your blessing, and we're so grateful for it. Every good thing that happens to all of us in this world, or the good changes that happen in this world, we know there's no doubt in our hearts why they've come about, and we're just so grateful to you for everything, for coming here to this world, and for helping right now. Thank you so much.
It's okay. Oh, we all do what we can, no?
Yeah.
It's also because you help, yeah? You go out, you give the flyers, yeah? And you translate for SMTV, gather information for SMTV. Everybody help.
Yes,
yeah?
But we are because of you.
I know. Yeah, okay. Somebody has to be the head, you know? I'm just there to, I mean, kind of guidance, you know, and everybody help. Yes.
You show us what to do.
Yeah. Well, because in my heart, I love people. I want them to be elevated, not just to save their lives, but to save their souls. Yes. If they truly sacrifice that piece of meat to save the planet, oh, then their merit is immense. They don't need to practice with me nothing. Just leave that meat alone, that's it. That's all there is to do. Then I can help them even more, you know?
Mm.
But you are there, you see? You help me to spread this news. It helps, everybody helps, you see? Yes. You help one person, and that one person help another person, and that person, you know, it's good. I'm so happy.
Vegetarianism in religion.
The Baha'i Faith. Regarding the eating of animal flesh and abstinence therefrom, know thou of a certainty that, in the beginning of creation, God determined the food of every living being, and to eat contrary to that determination is not approved. Selections from the Baha'i Writings of Some Aspects of Health and Healing.
Buddhism. All meats eaten by living beings are of their own relatives. Lankavatara Sutra. Also, after the birth of the baby, care must be exercised not to kill any animal in order to feed the mother with meaty delicacies, and not to assemble many relatives to drink liquor or to eat meat, because at the difficult time of birth, there are innumerable evil demons, monsters, and goblins who want to consume the smelly blood. By ignorantly and adversely resorting to the killing of animals for consumption, they bring down curses upon themselves, which are detrimental to both the mother and the baby. Kasitigarbha Sutra. Be careful during the days immediately after someone's death, not killing or destroying, or creating evil karma by worshipping or offering sacrifice to demons and deities, because such killing and slaughtering committed, or such worship performed, or such sacrifice offered, would not have even an iota of force to benefit the dead, but would entwine even more sinful karma into previous karma, making it even deeper and more serious. Thus, delay his rebirth to a good state. Karma means retribution. Kasitigarbha Sutra.
Gaudai. The most important thing is to stop killing, because animals also have souls and understand like humans. If we kill and eat them, then we owe them a blood debt. Teachings of the Saints.
Christianity. Meats for the belly, and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Holy Bible.
And while the flesh was yet between their teeth, ere it was chewed, the wrath of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord smote the people with a very great plague. Holy Bible.
Confucianism. All men have a mind which cannot bear to see the sufferings of others.
The superior man, having seen the animals alive, cannot bear to see them die. Having heard their dying cries, he cannot bear to eat their flesh. Mencius. Essenes.
I am come to end the sacrifices and feasts of blood, and if ye cease not offering and eating of flesh and blood, the wrath of God shall not cease from you. Gospel of the Holy Twelve.
Hinduism. Since you cannot bring killed animals back to life, you are responsible for killing them. Therefore, you are going to hell. There is no way for your deliverance. Adalila.
He who desires to augment his own flesh by eating the flesh of other creatures lives in misery in whatever species he may take his birth. Mahabharata Anu.
Islam. Allah will not give mercy to anyone except those who give mercy to other creatures. Hadith.
Do not allow your stomachs to become graveyards of animals. Hadith.
Jainism. A true monk should not accept such food and drink as has been specially prepared for him involving the slaughter of living beings. Sutrakatanga.
Judaism. And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eateth any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and will cut him off from among his people. Holy Bible. Blood meaning flesh.
Sikhism. Those mortals who consume marijuana, flesh, and wine, no matter what pilgrimages, fasts, and rituals they follow, they will all go to hell. Guru Granth Sahib.
Taoism. Do not go into the mountain to catch birds and nets, nor to the water to poison fishes and minnows. Do not butcher the ox that plows your field. Tract of the Quiet Way.
Tibetan Buddhism. The offering to the deities of meat obtained by killing animate beings is like offering a mother the flesh of her own child, and this is a grievous failure, the supreme path of discipleship.
Zoroastrianism. Those plants, I, Ahura Mazda, or God, rain down upon the earth to bring food to the faithful and fodder to the beneficent cow. Avesta.
Everybody knows that vegetarian diet is good for health and to save the planet. They will be awakening their own great, compassionate, loving self-nature, and then their level of consciousness will rise up automatically, and they will understand more than they ever did, and they'll be closer to heaven than what they are right now.
But it's too slow for my liking. You know, meanwhile, many people suffer. You know what I mean? A lot of people suffer. Right now we have like 25 million people displaced because of climate change. They are refugees, but nobody accepts them as refugees. That's the problem. They have problem, nobody helps them. You see what I mean? They're like a person without country. For everybody, it's easy to say, okay, they're refugees. But for them, it's hell. Every day they live without home, without a country, without a certain future. Not just for them, but for their children. They have children and grandchildren and all that. This is terrible for everybody to have to bear that. And they don't have to bear that. We could have changed it. You see? So the sooner we change, the better for everyone. So some of us have to do something, you know? We cannot keep waiting for the people who has the power to change. We have to do something. We have to do what we can. Remember the little bird who keeps flapping water to put out the forest fire? Yes, we do what we can. Yeah. Because there's no other choice, is there? Huh? We can't just close our eyes and let people die and suffer like that. We just have to try. Convince whoever we can, yeah? One suffering family less is already one family happy. You see what I mean? One person suffering less than is already one person lucky. Yeah, we just have to do it, okay? Right. Thank you anyway for all of you. By the way, I thank all of you for trying so hard and for, you know, working it with me, you know, because one person cannot do anything. I mean, the physical world is different. You see, different system. We have to work physically. So thank you for going out there to give the flyers to that person or this person, and thank you for translating this and that into your language and giving it to your own people, and do whatever you can. Before, when I go out alone, I also have a lot of stuff, you know. SOS, alternative living, and alcohol harm, and benefit of vegetarian diet and all that, and how many people eating vegetarian, what kind of VIP are vegetarian, and all that. I give it to whoever I can. Not as many as I would like, you know, but I also do it. You do it better because you're more free. You're freer, you know, freer to go around, freer for action. Yes, and you are more free to contact anybody, you know.
So please, I want to ask some good questions. Maybe this question want to improve me for my practice. First is how to control my monkey mind.
I think your neighbor can tell you, because they have same problem. They have more experience than I have. You tell her, huh? Just whenever it go away, you pull it back. That's it. That's the only way. Okay? Whenever you... Oh, where are you going? Oh, come back here. Okay? Every time. Come back here. Every time.
Sometimes I just shaking my head. Stop.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, yes.
And hey, then come back.
Yes, and come back again. Yeah, that's it. That's all they do all day. You don't see the head getting bigger? Because they keep shaking it all day. Whenever they meditate, they shake just like you. Come back! Stop it! You put the master videotape on the background, you know, low volume, and try to listen. And then it calms your mind. Even master music, reciting poetry, even sad poetry, it doesn't matter, as long as they have my voice, you will listen, and it will calm your mind, okay? And even if you don't understand the poetry, it's even better. As you don't sit there and say, oh my God, really, that's really nice. But you, if you don't understand, it's even good. Just listen anything, yeah. Tape, you know, talking, speech. Lecture, poetry, music. Yeah, just listen, okay?
I have been trying it, but sometimes the monkey keep jumping to Hollywood, to Bollywood.
Of course.
From the South Pole to the North Pole.
Sure, otherwise you don't have to come here anymore.
Thank you so much.
I come back later, okay? We just have to bear it, baby, huh? If you don't have that problem, you have other problems, you know? Some people have boyfriend problem. Some people have mother problem. We see you again, don't worry, okay?
Okay.
See you soon.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Miễn sao mình được gặp nhau là được rồi, ok ha?
Yeah.
Không biết ngồi đâu cũng được. Ngồi chồng lên nhau ba bốn. Không có chỗ khi ngồi chồng lên nhau ba bốn tình.
Gặp được sư phụ là được.
Ngồi lên vai á, cổng á, hiểu không? Người này cổng này kia. Người ốm ngồi lên trên. Người mập ngồi ở dưới. Cho nó ổn định.
Thế mà con sợ mập tối không dám ăn tối này.
Tối không dám ăn tối. Mà có nhà ngươi con gái sao sợ.
Bạn mấy ông Tây bụng bự không sợ.
Đàn bà nó sợ, đàn ông sợ gì.
Đàn ông bây giờ cũng muốn có eo.
Đàn ông cũng muốn có eo nữa.
Mà có đi lại nó khó.
Eo ơi.
Con lại nấu ăn ở nhà hàng ấy, thành ra phải nhanh nhẹn chứ mà đi lịch bịch ấy.
Lịch bịch người ta thấy nó ông ăn chay kiểu là tôi không dám. Bự khôn quá.
Đi lịch bịch không phục vụ cho nội khách.
Ok. Very good.
Con muốn nói cảm ơn sư phụ rất nhiều, tại vì sư phụ đã an bài cho bố mẹ con là anh trai cách đây được một tháng rồi là anh trai trường. Mà con không nghĩ tưởng tượng được là bố mẹ con là thay đổi anh trai như thế.
Tại sao? Tại sao thay đổi vậy?
Con thích con sư phụ nhiều.
Coi TV hả?
Con nhìn về con nói chuyện mấy lần, kêu con nói chuyện mới cái hết tâm của mình á. Mình nói cái tình thương thế là tự nhiên bố mẹ con thay đổi anh trai luôn.
Dạ. Very good. Bravo. Nếu mình thành tâm nhiều khi mình cảm động.
Dạ.
Cảm động người á.
Dạ.
Nếu mình có tình thương thật. Ok, very good.
Con điện về con nói chuyện mấy lần thấy con cầu sư phụ nữa. Đấy là
bắt từ làm việc nữa.
Mấy lần cái điện về sau rồi bố mẹ quyết định anh trai trường rồi.
Dạ. Ok, very good.
Thế là tụi con cứ mua đồ ăn đặt ở trên Hà Nội nhá, rồi gửi về tỉnh lẻ. Gửi về nhà, thế là ông bà già con cứ thế ăn. Dạ. Tại vì nhà con ở vùng quê mà ở tỉnh lẻ, không có đồ ăn chay.
Ây da, xíu đậu vậy mà sao ông bà không cảm động cho được.
Con cứ một tuần con phải điện người 4-5 lần nữa.
Yeah.
Cái hỏi chuyện này kia rồi đến hồi cái bày vô cách ăn uống.
Oh, wow. Tại vì ông bà không biết mà, nếu biết thì sẽ ăn thế đâu có sao.
Dạ. Yeah. Mà ông bà giờ con nói là ăn chay giờ thấy tốt rồi, tại vì tốt cho sức khỏe này kia.
Cảm thấy liền hả?
Dạ, ăn được một tuần đã nói thế.
Bây giờ mà những người mà nhiều khi bệnh tim á mà ăn chay nó hết liền á.
Dạ.
Tới mức vậy.
Dạ.
Tại vì ăn thịt là độc mà, độc dược á, thành ra ăn rồi cái thân thể nó cũng bị hư hoại.
Mẹ con là ngày trước con ăn chay là phản đối con nhiều nhất, mà đến hồi giờ này
như là ăn chay được.
Dạ.
Hết phản đối rồi.
Giờ này nói là ăn chay tốt.
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything changed. Possible. Tốt quá. Như vậy mà muốn nhiều người sẽ ăn chay thêm. Ok.
Dạ.
Mình hơi ốm làm việc nó hơi dễ dàng hơn, chạy nhanh nhẹn hơn ha.
Dạ. Yeah. Con nhìn ông mà
cũng sợ. Yeah. Mập quá sức ha.
Đi như lực bịch nữa.
Mập vừa vừa còn được ha, tròn trịa thì nó mập quá. Thấy hơi mệt ha.
Yeah.
Một ngày mà đem đeo trên mình có mười mấy kilo sao chịu. Mình có xách một bao gạo có 10 ký thôi. Chạy tới chạy luôn hồi thở ông mệt. Mập mấy chục ký thêm nữa, hiểu không? Mà ngày nào
cái cục thịt đi.
Thế nào cũng vác cục thịt đi. Nhưng mà đi nổi cũng hay hả? Mấy người đó mạnh khỏe thì hết chứ.
Đói mà thèm cơm, cứ ăn chút trái cây nè, đỡ một chút nè. Lại chứ không dám ăn cơm, ăn đồ nhiều.
Hay, ăn cơm đâu có mập đâu, ăn trái cây nhiều khi mập đó, nó ngọt á. ăn cơm đâu có phải mập. Ăn cái đồ mà có nhiều mỡ nó mới mập, hiểu chưa? Ví dụ mình ăn cơm mà mình ví dụ xào rau nữa, đừng có bỏ mỡ nhiều. Ví dụ thường thường mình bỏ 2 muỗng, bây giờ bỏ nửa muỗng thôi. Rồi bỏ thêm 1 muỗng rưỡi nước vô nữa. Nên xào lên nó cũng giống như là 2 muỗng dầu vậy đó. Nó bớt mập. Còn không thì ăn rau luộc á.
Đường hoặc là chocolate đó, cái đó nằm để làm cho mình mập bụng nữa.
Vì đừng có ăn mấy cái đó. Tôi cái gì tôi cũng ăn á, tôi cái gì tôi ăn đấy à. Thành ra bận đồ rộng dễ ăn. Bận eo với mấy cô đó thôi mà không. Ốc sao ốc sao cũng được, ok. Nếu mà không muốn mập á thì mình ăn cơm với rau thường nhiều á, đừng có cho dầu vô, hiểu không?
Dạ, dạ.
Dầu với bí ẩn bơ với đường này kia đó ha.
Dạ, cảm ơn.
Những cái thứ đó là nó mới làm mình mập. Còn nếu mà tệ quá còn muốn ăn nữa thì mua mấy cái thứ mà nó đề là diet á. Diet chocolate, diet bí ẩn butter này kia đó. Hình như nó cũng giảm bớt mà nhiều khi nó bỏ những cái thứ gì đâu mình không biết nữa. Diet không biết bỏ cái gì không tốt không biết nữa. Phải coi cho kỹ ha. Còn con này giảm bớt dầu mỡ đi thì nó bớt mập rồi, phải không? giảm bớt dầu mỡ, giảm bớt đường ha.
Dạ.
Giảm bớt những cái bột này, bột mì này kia đó ha. Cái thứ mà làm bằng bột mì ấy mà ha.
Dạ dạ.
À, ăn mà cơm á nó không có mập đâu.
Dạ.
Tại người ta nghiên cứu người ta thấy ăn cơm nó ít mập mà trẻ nhiều. Thì nó mấy người Á Châu họ trẻ nhiều không?
Dạ.
Họ trẻ lâu hơn là mấy người Tây phương không? À, tại mình ăn cơm á. Với lại ăn rau nhiều á hả?
Dạ.
Thí dụ người Việt Nam hay người Tàu ăn thịt thì cũng ít hơn là những người Tây phương ăn thịt, hiểu chưa?
Dạ.
Ăn thêm như gạo với lại rau chứ không phải ăn thịt không, phải không? Còn thí dụ người Mỹ họ ngồi là nguyên một cái dĩa là thịt không à. Để ăn cái miếng nhiều khi miếng thịt bò và to bằng cái dĩa vậy đó. Rồi trong đó có mỡ màng đủ thứ hả? Còn những độc dược cái trỏng rồi cũng ăn vậy thì nó bệnh hoạn mọc lên. Cái sự tiêu hóa nó không có điều hòa được á. Ăn mấy thứ độc dược của chúng mình so sánh ha, cả thế giới bị lừa gạt cái gì vậy? Ai da, nếu mình sống tới ngày nào mà toàn thế giới ăn chay hết là đỡ quá ha. Thì đó là khỏi SCTV vậy á. Khỏi cần á. Rồi cái ngày nào cũng đi làm xong lại thăm sư phụ xong. Ok.
À, thưa sư phụ, con có cái chuyện, một số chuyện mà về mỡ nhà hàng chay ở Việt Nam ơi sư phụ. Con về nước cũng rất nhiều lần từ đầu năm đến giờ. Nhưng mà thưa sư phụ là có một chuyện là con về thì con mở cái nhà hàng Âu Lạc Lobby Hood đó sư phụ. Nói chung trong đấy thì rất là đông. Sau đấy thì đến tháng 6 thì con lại khai trương cái Lobby Hood ở Hà Nội. Ở Hà Nội thì hiện tại bây giờ chúng con vẫn duy trì được cái đấy. Mà khách cũng đông. Ở Đà Nẵng thì cũng rất đông sư phụ. Ngày rằm mùng 1 thì không đủ người phục vụ. Nói chung là mọi người ăn chay rất thay đổi ăn chay rất nhiều sư phụ ạ. Vâng. Với lại khi mà được tin của sư phụ ấy sư phụ, thì ở trong nước, ở đặc biệt là Hà Nội với lại Hải Phòng, thì đồng tu và thanh niên nhà mình nói chung là con thấy là có một cái sự thay đổi rất lớn. Và kể cả những người xung quanh ở khu phố, hoặc là khi nói chuyện với những người mà trước kia mình đã nói chuyện và người ta biết, thì đến bây giờ nhà hàng chay mình mọc lên rất là nhiều. Thế nên vậy, cho nên là con thấy mọi người chính ở thủ đô cũng như là ở trong miền Nam thì không nói sư phụ ạ, từ Huế hất vào bên trong thì mọi người ăn chay rằm mùng 1, một tháng ăn chay 4 lần hoặc là người ta ăn nhiều hơn thì rất là tốt. Nhưng mà thời gian gần đây thì con thấy mọi người thay đổi. Mà cộng với cái tin vui của sư phụ nữa thì nói chung
tin
là
vui gì?
Từng ngày từng giờ mà mọi người theo dõi từ 2 năm á sư phụ, đến xong rồi bây giờ đến lại 4 năm thì nói chung là rất nhiều thông tin là từ đồng tu tới những người khác, người ta rất quan tâm đến vấn đề của thế giới sư phụ.
Nóng toàn cầu đó hả?
Dạ vâng.
Thời gian kéo dài đó hả?
Dạ vâng, cái thời gian kéo dài. Mà khi như vậy thì
sao mở được nhà hàng nào mở đâu có sao, để giúp đỡ người ta ăn chay mà. Miễn là ăn chay thôi, ok.
Chúng con cũng cố gắng làm việc sư phụ, rồi mình làm được những cái cho tức trước mắt là người thân mình biết được ăn chay với tất cả mọi cái, thì okay. Những cái đấy mình đỡ hơn. Rồi mở được cái chỗ cái quán chay thì có người ta đến người ta ăn ấy sư phụ. Tại vì không có quán thì người ta cũng không ăn được. Phải có chỗ bán, có chỗ nấu thì người ta ăn thì nó thuận tiện thì người ta mới ăn sư phụ. Nhưng mà con thấy là thay đổi, rất thay đổi. Nhưng mà ở trong miền Nam mình thì ăn thoải mái, nhưng ngoài Hà Nội thì cầu kỳ lắm sư phụ.
À.
Cho nên rất khó.
Đi đâu, chỗ nào làm giống chỗ đó mà, ok?
Dạ vâng.
Nhập gia tùy tục hết.
Dạ.
Thank you. Người nào mở được nhà hàng ở đâu thì mở ha, Loving Hood được cũng được, không Loving Hood thì cũng không sao, ok?
Dạ vâng.
Miễn là phục vụ ăn chay làm việc cho sạch sẽ, thấy không?
Dạ.
Chân ngon lành là ok rồi, để cái mục đích là cho phục vụ quần chúng, hiểu chưa?
Dạ vâng.
Sao cũng được, ok. Không có gì đâu, ăn chay không có gì đâu. Còn nếu mà muốn làm có nhiều cái món ăn mà nếu mà mình muốn làm giống như Loving Hood á,
dạ,
thì hỏi người ta cho cái recipe đó chứ gì đâu.
Dạ vâng, công thức.
À, còn nếu không không làm được giống như tại bên Việt Nam nhiều khi ăn khác á.
Dạ, vâng.
Nhưng mà nếu mình muốn có nhiều món ngon của quốc tế, nếu mình muốn làm thử cho người Việt Nam có thích ăn không á.
Dạ vâng, có.
Thì kêu công thức của họ làm thử, nếu mà bán được thì bán, không bán được thôi làm dạ. Cái khác. Ok chứ?
Con cũng nghĩ như vậy, mà chúng con cũng quyết tâm đó sư phụ. Cũng cố gắng học theo để mình làm phục vụ được nhiều.
Miễn là có người ăn chay là ok rồi hả? Thì buôn bán phải tùy theo khách hàng chứ hả? Thành nãy sư phụ mới nói rồi, miễn đã ăn được là ok rồi, không cần biết hơn loving food hay là cái gì food gì đó. Cái food gì cũng được đó. Miễn người ta vô người ta hopper được rồi. Không, mình sửa thành loving hop cũng được. Hấp hấp cháo chay á.
Người Tây không thấy người ta đơn thuần ăn đấy. Con làm phở cho người ta bữa hôm mà đông khách mà hết ớt cay rồi còn cho ớt đỏ vô.
Nó cũng ok này.
Dạ, thành người quen với người ta. Mùi hôm nay ta ăn không thấy mùi cay cay mà nó khác thế nào. Ừ, đúng rồi, tôi xin lỗi anh. Thế là hôm nay ớt nhà tôi hết rồi. Thế là ở quán, ở tiệm đây cũng không có nữa.
Tôi nhậu hết rồi.
Đi cho ớt đỏ chứ.
Cũng ngon vậy đâu có sao. Mai mốt phải mua một cái nhà kho, hiểu chưa? Đặng mà để ớt. Mướn cái nhà kho để chứa ớt. Kêu bằng kho ớt. Chứ không phải ớt kho. Quý vị làm sao cũng được. Cái lớp in hút đó là đại ý nó những người nào muốn làm theo giống kiểu của bên Đài Loan đó mà. Ok?
Dạ.
Còn nếu mà không làm kiểu đó, làm kiểu khác cũng không có sao đâu. Ok hả?
Vâng.
Cái đó là kêu bằng guideline thôi, hiểu không?
Vâng.
Là cái sự chỉ dẫn general đó, hiểu không?
Vâng.
Người nào muốn để cái tên đó hay là muốn học theo cái cách đó thì cũng được. Còn không thì cứ mở tiệm nào cũng được mà, hiểu chưa? Miễn ta ăn chay mà làm ngon lành đó ha. Người ta ăn nhiều là ok rồi, hiểu chưa?
Vâng.
Điều quan trọng là người ta ăn chay, hiểu không?
Vâng.
Nếu người nào không biết kiểu nấu làm sao thì hỏi ok thì nấu như vậy đi ha.
Vâng.
Giống như lớp viên hút vậy đó, muốn thì nấu. Để nó thành giống như là cái hiệu rồi đó, hiểu không?
Vâng.
Nó vô đó là nó biết nó ăn cái gì vậy đó ha, hiểu không? Ý như vậy đó. Còn nếu không là làm khác cũng được, không sao đó. Làm gì ăn cũng được mà ha. Ăn ngon là ok. Việt Nam mà chắc cũng phải nó hơi khác khác chút ha.
Khác
phụ à, món hơi khác. Không sao đâu. Làm thử mà ha, ok.
À, dạ thưa sư phụ, con có một cái thắc mắc như thế này. Ở Âu Châu thường thích ăn đồ Á Châu. Còn ở Áo đó thì các đồng tu có mở rồi một cái nhà hàng rất là nhỏ. Nhưng mà con thấy theo cái ý kiến của con á, là mình bán trong đó nó vừa loving food, vừa những cái thức ăn Á Châu.
Cái đó sư phụ nói rồi, tức là loving food chỉ có một hai món gì đó thôi. Còn những một cái chỗ địa phương nào đó phải cho thêm những cái món của địa phương vô đó.
Giống như ở ngoài Hà Nội của con á sư phụ, ở Đà Nẵng thì con làm rất là nhiều món bún rồi lại mì Quảng các kiểu, con đem ra Hà Nội bán, nhưng mà một hai tuần sau không bán được sư phụ.
Hà Nội chỉ có,
chỉ
bán
có một
phở
thôi.
Không phải, còn ở miền Nam bán rau muống là không ba không ai ăn hết, chưa đem rau muống, đem rau muống vô miền Nam, đem rau giá lên miền Bắc là không ai ăn hết á. Nhiều khi mình làm một hai món đặc biệt cho người khách người ta thử một hai tuần nào đó ha, ví dụ nó tuần này có thêm món đặc biệt ha, à, bún riêu ha của bà bầu nào đó à, tuần này đặc biệt thôi ví dụ đó ha. À, người nào muốn bún riêu vô đó ăn, còn tuần sau mình làm món đặc biệt khác, hiểu không?
Yeah.
Đó là ngoài những cái món chính đó, mình muốn làm món thêm này kia đó, nếu thấy mà khách hàng ăn nhiều thì mình làm tiếp.
Yeah.
Mình kêu bằng mình thay đổi mà ha. Lâu lâu có một món khác vậy đó ha. Còn những cái món nào nó chính thì mình có đó, những món nào mà người khách thường ăn hoài thì mình để đó, hiểu chưa?
Yeah.
Những món nào lâu lâu mình muốn thử coi có khách có muốn ăn không là thêm món đó mà ha. À, mình thử một tuần hai tuần vậy đó. Tuần này cái gì, tuần kia cái gì vậy đó. Ok.
Yeah.
Hoặc là ngày nay có gì, ngày kia có gì ha.
Phải thay đổi liên tục của sư phụ. ngày nào bọn con làm cơm bọn con cũng thay đổi liên tục.
Ừ, sư phụ là con muốn khoe với sư phụ là chúng con ở bên tiệc mới mở quán chay á được 5 tháng rồi, nhưng mà nhờ sư phụ gia trì rất là nhiều. Bất cứ một người khách nào vào quán chúng con ra đều khen.
Dạ. Yeah.
Thức ăn thì rất là ngon.
Bác sư phụ làm món đó hả?
Chúng con không hiểu sao mà khách, bất cứ một người khách nào vào đi ra đều cảm ơn mà rất thích cái quán của chúng con.
À.
Bởi chúng con bảo là đúng là thức ăn chỉ có sư phụ gia trì mới có như thế này thôi, người nào vào ăn cũng úi dồi ôi ngon lắm. Chưa từng thấy ở món ăn nào ngon như thế này.
À, tại quý vị thành tâm có lòng thương
mà chúng con tốt. Thì chỉ có là rau xanh rồi tươi ngon. À. Chủ đề của chúng con là cứ làm tươi ngon và ngon miệng dễ ăn cho người ta. Hàng ngày thay đổi, khách đến ăn rất là thích sư phụ. Ai cũng
ngon.
Thích
cứ vào ngon sạch sẽ.
Vâng, dạ. Người nào vào
mà đồng ý á.
Chưa có
đúng rồi như vậy đó,
quên
vậy mới được á.
Mà chê cả.
Vâng. Nhẹ nhàng mà làm việc thánh thản nhẹ nhàng gì đâu, cực khổ quá. Mệt quá ăn nuốt không vô. Chưa ăn mà mệt.
Họ vào thích lắm mà xem rồi những cái thông tin của sư phụ. Người ta rất vào đấy đều xem mà mà mang về đều thích. Cứ người nọ được quảng cáo cho người kia đến là cứ dẫn khách khách đến thêm cho chúng con thôi.
Phải có lòng tin hả?
Dạ
mình
vâng.
Được. Ừ. Mình tu hành có sức gia trì không sợ. Ờ, bữa nay nấu món này người ta không ăn, ngày mai mình nấu món khác gì đâu hả?
Vâng.
Chuyện nó phải uyển chuyển chứ hả?
Vâng.
Ở nhà hàng bên tiệp á sư phụ, bọn con mở SMTV ấy, với lại băng sách của sư phụ ấy, người tiệp người ta đón nhận mà người ta hoan hỷ lắm. Người ta vào ăn biết hay không biết, hoặc là người ta theo bất cứ một cái đạo khác nhé sư phụ nhé. Mà người ta vẫn lịch sự, người ta vẫn xem và người ta vẫn tìm hiểu.
Phải có lòng tin mãnh liệt, phải có cái lòng phụng sự chúng sanh, phải có lòng thương loài vật. Để có lòng thành kính với ai vô, người ta cũng cảm thấy cái bầu không khí đó. Hả? Mà không sao đâu, này có nhiều khi có những cái chỗ nó hơi khó khăn vậy mà. Hả? Thì đâu phải chỗ nào cũng vậy. À. Chỗ nào khó thì mình nhẫn nại. Hả? Còn chỗ nào mà khỏe thì mình ngồi chơi xơi nước. Hả? Nếu mà làm việc nào cũng dễ dàng như mà mình thích như vậy thì chắc sư phụ khỏi ngồi đây rồi, khỏi làm việc nữa, khỏi đi nói gì mà công ha. Giơ tay ra, rồi tôi làm xong hết rồi. Chuyện cái thế giới này đâu có dễ đâu, dễ thì đúng là cái phước báo của mình, ok? Cái duyên của mình là sướng lắm, còn cái chuyện không dễ mình cũng phải làm. Ngồi đó nói hoài nó cũng khó à, hiểu chưa?
Con thấy là cứ tin tưởng sư phụ làm thì cái gì cũng rất là thích. Vâng, bất kể một từ khi chúng con mới mở á, là khó khăn nhưng mà cứ chưa kịp cầu sư phụ đã ăn bài rồi. Rồi thần kỳ ghê vô cùng với sư phụ ạ.
Bá lật đật quá. Bá muốn độ toàn thế giới thành làm gì bá cũng lẹ lẹ chứ làm chậm như mấy người á. Người ta đi xuống địa ngục hết rồi.
Thế là sư phụ ăn bài cực kỳ là thề nhiệm màu. Chúng con ở bên đấy mỗi một lúc như thế chỉ có biết nhìn nhau, đúng là sư phụ ở lại gia trì rồi, lại ăn bài cho rồi. Những cái lúc cần thì sư phụ gửi đến rất là nhanh. Những cái lúc như thế, nhưng mà chúng con thấy nếu như các đồng tu nào mà mở quán chay thì chắc chắn là thành công, bởi vì sao, lúc nào sư phụ cũng ủng hộ 100% với như bây giờ. Đấy là điều con muốn nói với mọi người là như thế. Thì từ con thấy ra là lúc nào cũng được sư phụ chăm sóc rất là cẩn thận.
Nếu mà mình thật tình muốn hả, muốn phục vụ chúng sanh hả, bảo vệ loài vật kia, lúc nào sư phụ cũng giúp đỡ, lúc nào cái lực lượng của sư phụ đó, lực lượng bên trong của quý vị á, sư phụ cũng giúp đỡ hết á. Tại vì mình quên đi nên mình sợ này sợ kia hả. Nhưng mà thật ra thế giới nó cũng hơi khó khăn chứ đâu phải dễ dàng, phải không? Nhưng mà khó khăn mình phải làm chứ hả, không làm thì càng khó hơn.
Mình phải quyết tâm hả sư phụ?
Thì từ ban đầu mình làm nó hơi khó, sau càng ngày càng dễ, không? Thêm bao nhiêu người làm nữa thì càng ngày càng dễ rồi. Mai mốt nguyên thế giới đều ăn chay hết.
Vâng.
Là dễ rồi ha. Đi đâu ngồi xuống cũng có đồ ăn chay, phải sướng không? À. Nhiều khi hồi đó sư phụ đâu có chỗ đồ ăn chay đâu, nhiều khi muốn đi tìm quán chay rất là khó khăn. Bây giờ mình cứ mở ra đi, Ví dụ không, nếu mà mệt quá không muốn làm cả ngày thì làm ban đêm cũng được hả? Mở nghĩa là mà ăn tối thôi, ví dụ vậy đó hả? Hoặc là mở ăn trưa thôi, hiểu không? À, nếu thêm đồng tu vô giúp đỡ hoặc là ai là mướn thêm người gì đó làm được cả ngày thì càng tốt. Tùy theo sức mình ha. Nhưng mà làm là cái thành công có gì đâu, nấu ăn không gì hả? Nếu mình không biết nấu thì mình học thêm của mấy người lớp Vinhood đó hả? Mình chế biến thêm những cái món nào khác ra, hiểu không? Tùy theo địa phương.
Bây giờ trên trang mạng của mình rất nhiều món ăn sư phụ. Sắp vỡ mình bán mình học.
Học mấy người đó cũng nấu cũng được vậy, ok.
Con học cái món nấu ăn ở cái cuốn sách của sư phụ là hủ tiếu xào Thái Lan đó. Nhà hàng con bây giờ bán đắt nhất cái món đó. Cũng nhiều người ăn nhất. Bán tới giá tiền đắt nhất. Con được cái món này là phải bán đắt nhất.
Đắt nhất là sao? Tại vì nó mắc tiền hả?
Tại vì món đó là nấu tôm có nhiều thứ rau là 9-10 thứ nữa, còn là tofu nữa, nói chung là cũng ngon, thành ra con bán đắt nhất. mà cái món của sư phụ.
Món gì của sư phụ?
Cái món đó con nấu theo cái công thức của sư phụ đó.
Đâu, cái sư món đó, hủ sư tiếu xào Thái Lan.
Dạ.
Có hả? Sư phụ nấu?
Có.
Trong cái quyển sách
của Gia Tránh đó. Mọi người nấu chứ không phải một mình
Gia Tránh đó.
Sư phụ cũng biết nấu món đó nữa, nó kêu Thái Lan nó kêu là Pad Thai á. Pad Thai, P-A-D and Thai. Pad Thai. Đó là Thai noodle. Nhưng mà thường thường của Thái thì nó bỏ tôm, bỏ đều, hết chưa? Thì của mình thì mình bỏ đậu hũ.
Con cứ xem thế là thành phần đó là con nấu ra.
Nấu đại vậy mà cũng bán đắt nhất.
Dạ.
Người tiệm của ta dễ ăn
lắm. Thuần lắm. Người ta dễ ăn. Dạ.
Dạ, bán đắt nhất. Ok. Đấy.
Nhưng mà nói là đắt thôi chứ mình nói là đắt nhất của mình thôi.
À, hiểu rồi.
Còn giá của mình vẫn là thấp.
Đúng rồi. Vừa phải ha.
Dạ vâng.
Đắt nhất trong quầy nhà hàng thôi.
Hiểu rồi. Very good. Yeah, I'm happy for you.
Có mấy đứa trẻ bây giờ khoảng 20 tuổi đó, trưa người ta cần ăn chay đó sư phụ. Thành ra thấy mấy cái chẳng hạn như sandwich rồi này kia, mấy cái đó hơi thiếu. Tại vì tụi nó ăn, mấy đứa trẻ nó đâu có tiền nhiều nữa, nó đi ăn nhà hàng, thành ra kêu nó ăn đơn giản thôi.
Mà nhiều đứa làm sandwich
thì mình làm sandwich, vẫn làm được sandwich sư phụ.
Làm gì sandwich gì ở. Okay, I'm going now. You guys meditate.
Thank you for this wonderful night. Have a good
mùa đàn chim cánh nho chờ mùa sang, chiều vào thu tiếng em xô lạnh gió, lá trên cành một chiếc cuối bay xa, xa nhau chưa mà lòng sao lạnh vắng. Mở đàn chim cánh nhỏ chờ mùa sáng. Yeah. Very good. Where from?
New Zealand.
Oh, New Zealand. Holland. Đêm chưa đi. Đêm chia ly ngày giờ sao chẳng nói. Một đàn chim cánh nho chờ mùa sang, chiều vào thu tiếng em sao lạnh giá,
song of goodbye. Nở trên cành một chiếc cuối bay xa, xa nhau chưa mà lòng sao lạnh giá. Mở đàn chim cánh nhỏ chờ mùa sang.
Ukraine, lucky people, lucky people. Ukraine, lucky people.
Yeah, I made a new painting. You know the last one on the left side, very green and red and blue and purple. Yeah. You know what their name? It's called saying a glorious goodbye. When the autumn leaves falling, they're so beautiful. It's a glorious goodbye. Đêm chia ly ngại gì sao chẳng nói. Chỉ nghe em nức nở trở về tôi. Cô sẵn hơi chị vậy sao?
Mấy giống hồ lên trang cho một khoai lợi mình cụ cải mà. Đi dê. Chứ mà khoai lợi, hả?
Cô sẵn chăn cơ kể này, mình khăn chế quá này, mình cụ chưa cái dạng gì. Sáng không ngủ, sáng làm việc cả đêm, mà sáng đêm giờ này còn hát cho mấy người nghe nữa mà không mà khóc.
Nãy chưa chị thêm đâu, có thấy thầy sư phụ rồi mà, phải không? À. Chiến thiên có thấy không? Thấy rồi. Đúng rồi, chính là chẳng chỉ là không thấy. Bản lai cho sư phụ làm tôi xem một lần cho hảo rồi. 然后看了一眼，就看两眼、三眼、四眼，这看多少不够？我多看几眼了。本来我说我就过不来了，我回家，就过来多看你们几眼了。不想回家哈？为什么？哎呀，好可怜。怎么办呢？想师父的话，要多修行，以后我们永久在一起的。这个，有时候有问题，世界是这样嘛哈，业障啊哈。我知道你们舍不得了，我也不是喜欢你们走，事实上这样子，哪里走该什么的哈。大家住在一起，我最喜欢这样子。不过，如果每个是这样子的话，就没有人在外面传播那个好消息，懂吗？所以上帝安排呢，我们自己有帮助的地方了啊。人是有家庭啊，有工作啊，有房子啊，有政府啊，等等啊。因为这样子，我们才能够离开嘛。如果没有这样子，谁就不想离开。我也不想离开你们，我每一个我都想保留的，真的是这样。唉，多好哈！如果我们能够在一起住哈，天天多好哈。Yeah。不过世界比较有紧急嘛，大家牺牲一下哈，即使能留也要牺牲哈，因为替别人着想哈。现在你们这么痛苦，既然已经认识师父，有宝法可以修行，还这么那么痛苦，才那么念，那想到别人外面多痛苦，一点点都没有。法门那个正法有不少的，懂不懂？等一下死了不少去哪里了？你们即使死了上去地，不管地去那个。第一界也好，也会看到师父在那里，跟教员一样，那边又更方便，那边又更方便。一想到师父，师父就在了，就这边想到师父，师父在也看不到，师父来也看不到，因为被撤掉嘛。在那个即使第一界呢，阿修罗世界而已，
不是下地狱不一样哦，下地狱是活该的，我已经告诉你们那个天堂的路了。其实我意思说最糟糕就是你们去那个阿修罗的境界，那一边天天看到师父无所谓的，这边看不到，天天师父跟你们在一起，在你们家跟你们在车上啊，去跟你们坐火车的，跟你们耕田，跟你们吃饭啊，你们根本都看不到。上面都比较容易看到师父，因为没有这个肉体绑啊。这个肉体当然很有帮助，不过也是跟那个房子一样，懂吗？房子是很舒服，住里面很温暖，对呀，没风没雨，不过有一撤掉啊，懂吗？啊，外面看不到，前面那个边的海也看不到，外面树木看不到，了解吗？哎呀，被也是被挡住了，被绑在里面。我们是需要房子，对了哈，要保护嘛，要安全。那我们家庭都需要房子哈，为了安全嘛。不过房子也是被绑住我们很多，而且要修理啊，要负担很多事情啊，要付税金，要修理，要修改，要买这个，要买那个，啊，同样啊，这个房子也是很麻烦。比方说，师傅整个晚上在这里啊，不过因为我在另外一个房子，你们在这个房子，你们看不到师傅有没有？不过你们有一个房子也温暖，可以打坐休息，有没有？啊，不过有房子就是看不到师父了。同样，在这个世界是这样子啊，师父随时跟你们在的，就是被这些房子忙嘛挡住了。所以不要说想念师父看不到师父，看得到了，灵魂都看得到的。那个就不一样啊，就不一样。好好 ，OK， 我懂。不过我们要牺牲嘛哈，不然整个世界没人救哦。
你不知道是为什么总是不满足，其实感觉到师父总是在身边，总是不满足。
我懂 ，Oh my God， 像爱人一样哎，奇怪，你不满足，啊？
爱人可以丢掉，师父丢不掉。
丢，他不让你丢，他就跟着黏的吗？哎呀，这个师父很困难哈，麻烦，谁叫你们那个有那种师父吗？啊 ，I am so sorry。对不起，
不爱任何人都行，啊，就不能不爱师傅了。
哎呀呀，都是你们了。
对不起，师傅。
嗯，啊，不是不是，我不是说你们错，就是麻烦自己的。干什么？
感谢师傅对我的爱，感谢师傅的加持。
我们第二次来见您了，
真的。
哎，九月份我们来一次，我们很顺畅，签得很顺畅。
第二次已经很好了。
哎，上次师傅加持我们好多，这次又有加持我们。
怎么还哭？
这次又加持我们，一切都非常顺畅。
Good.
谢谢师父。
不客气。哎呀，好可爱，好可怜。我真的不知道怎么办，这节就这样啊，魔王都造成这样子。所以你们赶快修行嘛啊！师父在不在就修行，修赶快，他等一下上去，即使第一届也看到师父，第二、第三、第四、第五都看到了，跟这边一样。不过就是简单看到，没有被那个限制，了解吗？一想就到了，不用签证，不用飞机，不用花钱。这个世界是像地狱一般，真的是这样，没什么好东西。我如果不是为了成就这些困难的人，我一秒不想留。
拜托师傅多留一下。
留有时候压力很大，懂不懂？连师傅也受不了，哇，有时候快爆炸了。
师傅，我们一定好好休息，不用报答
你。没有，不用报答，就行，自己解脱就好了，报什么答？能报什么答？我不是要报答，就是想你们修行解脱嘛，自己自在、自由啊，快乐，就师傅高兴了。就像你们有小孩嘛，哈。你们小孩快乐高兴自在，你也是很高兴的，
啊，
根本不用他报答什么也 OK， 反正他健康快乐哈，自由自在，让你们父母就很高兴。我心也是这样，一模一样。呀，因为这样子世界的人师父才留下来这个世界，不然根本不用留。
师父，你一定保重您的身体，祝你永远健康快乐，年轻美丽。
Thank you。 即使留这个世界，也不用工作这么累了，懂不懂？一个人的话需要多少嘛，啊，反正吃饭什么都简单的，有一个山洞住就 OK 了。嗯，好了，那如果你们认为师父辛苦的话，你们回去要那个努力奋斗一下哈，牺牲一下哈，为了成就别人。嘿，
是，我们一定记住，一定记住，下次我们还来看你。
好，我也会有机会的。在这个世界是要尊重国家的法律，
是，
没有的话我们也是更被限制，知道哈，更被限制。 OK 了，乖乖了。
谢谢师父。
几点要走啊？
我们明天。
有一些明天，有一些马上走。
我们是今天11点到12点。
哦，快的哈，现在快9点了呢。好，
我们多看你一眼。
懂。
谢谢师父。
好，不客气不客气。呀，我就知道你们很爱看师父了，我知道，反正你们能看多少天就看多少天了。总比美好，嘿。
谢谢师父，我们已经很满足了，师父。
啊。
师父的力量越来越大了。
都到集市的时候，分着假期，我们都出去发单页，各种部门我们都发了。他们坐在那儿看，可仔细、认真的看。
是是。
这都是师父的爱力，师父的力量越来越大，加持力也是，把环境现在都已经改变了。嗯，谢谢师父。
不过做弟子也得认真去做，做的越多，他的气氛越好。
啊、对对。对，所以我才说你们牺牲嘛，就像我喜欢做的东西我也放下来嘛，是为了大众，所以你们也是这样子，喜欢的东西也放下来，喜欢师父也要放下来，这样子才是真正的喜欢师父。 OK， 好， Thank you， 听懂啊。
有时候我们只能一个人出去发传单，他还告诉我们多组织几个人，一个人好像力量小一点，
越快。对了，
说形势越来越好了。
是是，而且善良的人到处都有了，就我们多修行的人就会碰到那些修行不够就碰到糟糕的。
有些那个退休的什么都支持我们这样做。哦、
太好了。 OK，
是形势越来越好，
很多人现在吃素了，都是谢谢你们的勤劳。
嗯，也看师父的网站，无上师电视台。
哦、OK，对嘛，看就知道。 我去下面了，有人哭在下面。
谢谢师父。
谢谢师父。
再见师
父。我告诉你哈，即使我24小时都看人头啊，也看不够。所以亮姐哈，
好，
给妈妈很忙啊。
妈妈再见。
是啊，我现在告诉我的狗哈，每次他们撒叫的时候，我说这个时候啊，不是要求的时候，这个时候是要贡献的，你们也要听着，要让我安静工作，因为有时候工作他在旁边吵嘛，牛啊，牛奶那句又是撒叫啊，我说这个时候不是要求的时候，这个时候是要给的，不是要拿的时候。因为我们世界很紧急啊 ，OK， 他们也很乖，都听，每个人都不动。
师父，我能不能问一个问题啊？很简单的，因为我是做素点心的，素点心做了11年了，但是就遇到那个采购那个原料的时候啊，比如说油吧，比如说豆沙馅吧，就里面的那个。我自己很难保证它没有动物成分。现在上次我在电视台里呢，看到有个同学说白糖里面也有动物成分哈，但是你就是师傅发下来的一个资料里面就是说红糖里面也有，就是程度不一样。所以现在就是同学呢，因为现在牛奶不能吃嘛，同学都要我们要常年的做素点心，他们因为在外面完全不能吃东西。后来我就考虑到这个问题，你说红糖它也说有动物成分。
没有红糖，就是那种自然的糖，不会有什么的。
谢谢师傅。
Indonesian. How is everybody? You develop.
I'm happy.
Happy, that's why, like Buddha, like, you know, Maitreya Buddha. Everything okay?
Yeah, it's getting better.
Human have too much freedom, too much free will, and sometimes make trouble. Your parents okay?
Yeah, fine. My dad still loves you.
He's still there, huh?
Yes.
Okay, good. As long as they vegetarian, yeah? And they keep the five precepts. Even if they don't go to the high level, at least they don't go to hell. It's okay, you're all free. Yeah? After initiation, or you keep five precepts, if
vegetarian.
That's enough for me. For you, the guys who have been through fire, and you shine like gold, you know? Gold never afraid of fire. They say, the more fire, the more shiny. Yeah? So you've been through many tests. Not just my tests, outside tests, you know? You've been through many tests already. So you deserve a good place. So what I mean is, you are very good, okay? Even if you practice lousy, at least, at least you trust me. And your trust is enough. Of course, you're not perfect, yeah, yet, okay? I don't expect you to be. At least you trust me, yeah? And that's important. If you don't trust a guy, you better leave him. Yeah, you don't know where he takes you. Remember the joke, huh? I don't know who wrote it. Because sometimes they give me by internet, you know? They got it from internet and they give it to me and I read it to you. Or sometimes I found it on internet myself or somewhere else. Newspaper or something, or somebody told me and I told you. Remember the joke about the guy in Maine? You know, Canada and New York and Maine are next to each other, yeah? And sometimes there's no barrier, no frontier. You just walk over, or there's a river, you cross over or something. There was a guy who took a group of tourists, you know? Walk around, remember? And then they all get lost and the guy said, I think, maybe we are lost. So the group said, but I thought you said you are the best tourist guys in Maine. Maine is next to New York, next to Canada. He said, yes, yes, I am, but I think we are in Canada now.
I like that joke very much. I always like that joke. Every time I talk about it, I laugh myself silly. I tell everybody in coffee shop, wherever I can see other people, I tell them this joke. This is a problem with the blind leading the blind, you know. It's very, very, very similar to, you know, some blind face situation, eh? Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah? So if you don't trust the guy, leave him. Yeah? And if you're definitely sure that he's the best tourist guy, then stick with him. Otherwise, you get more lost, you know. You're already halfway through. If you know the way back to where you are, okay, fine. If not, just stick with the guys. At least you get lost together. And you have food, you know. You have company. You go back alone and get lost even worse, no? In the spiritual jungle, there is also tricks and traps, yeah? So if you don't have a good guy, it's better you don't go. And if you have a guy, you better know for sure that he's good. And if you don't know he's good, you're not sure, you better not go with him. Understand? So it is good that you are sure. It's good for you. Mm? Yeah. We don't have enough room. You know how many people we have to sit like this and no room to sleep, you know? Here, you can sit on top of each other. Still not enough place. You know, you have to share your master with whoever, you know, whatever. And the master, where is she? Oh, LA conference. And tomorrow, oh, Taiwan conference. And next day, where is she? Oh, German conference. Yeah. And is she talking about what conference all the time? Oh, SOS. Global warming, global cooling, whatever she's doing, God knows. Yeah? So when will she ever has time for you? She visits all the time in my meditation. But just I don't see her. My wisdom is too lazy to open. She said she comes all the time, but only she knows. Strange. Sometimes my kids know, but I don't know. Or even sometimes my neighbor, who is even not initiated, told me that my master come to see me. It's strange. What kind of master? Who let the neighbor see? Let the children see, but don't let me see. Yeah, yeah, ask yourself. See what I mean? Yeah? Truly, I'm not here just for you guys. You know, I'm here for everyone else, including animals. Oh, which are not many masters are doing, yeah? So mostly I do it alone. And you gotta help me instead of demanding, okay? I think it's good also that we come and go, yeah? Because your longing is also your progress, yes. And also one more thing is that you go home, you bless the country where you live. You have connection with them. You see what I mean? You bless your country, you bless your neighbor, your family, and you spread the good news, yeah? You influence people to live a more compassionate and good life, yeah? So instead of just clinging to what you want, you do what you should, yeah? We don't always have what we like, so we should like what we do. For example, if before, suppose I just stay in my Himalaya, in my cave and enjoy myself, then you won't be here even, right? And then because the people before you will not be with me. And then because they're not with me, they won't tell you, and you won't be here. And then if you're not here, you won't tell the next person. You see, that's how the world is helped. You know, through you also, yeah? Through me, but then through you also. You like my hand, my feet, you know? You go everywhere. You reach everybody for me. And that's how we help each other, yeah? Because not only we help other people, but also help our children, you know, to live in a better environment in the future. Huh? Your children are initiated maybe, but if everybody else is not, it's also not nice, yeah? First, not nice for the people who are not vegetarian or are not good. Second, not nice for you and for your children. We all influence each other anyway, yeah? So just a sacrifice we have to do. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad that you're still here, you trust me. And the people who came after even they have not been tested. But even if they come now, they already trust. You see what I mean? It's the same with you. So they join in the group. We are more connected. We are more united. You know, we're more in the same goal. We look through the outside. You see what I mean? So what I mean is you see through it, yeah? Just like I see through you. I see through your defects. I see through your colors. I see through your nationalities and personalities and even ego. Because I see you. You're true you. Yeah, so I trust you. Mm-hmm. And also the same way you trust me, because you can see through me. Yeah, you don't see my lipstick, you don't see my blonde hair or black hair, you don't see my glamorous clothes, you don't see my high heel, you don't see my bare feet, you don't see nothing like that. You just see me for myself. In that case, we can work together easier. You understand me? Yeah, because we like one, you know, we understood each other. And we have no barrier, no obstruction, no doubt, nothing that make us feel distance from each other. You see what I mean? That's why we can work. And you see how stronger and stronger we're working now, everywhere. You see what I mean? Yes. If we don't have this trust between us, like the way we do now, it's not possible to have done what we have done. Right? To have accomplished what we have accomplished. Yeah, and to progress the way we have progressed. Yes. So I'm very happy. I'm very proud of you. And I thank you for your trust. All of you. Mm-hmm.
I'll see you later, or if you stay. Love you too.